Heavy downpours by tomorrow morning. Look at Vulcan all aglow there this evening. Nice and warm outside for trick-or-treating. Still in the mid to upper 70s. 76 in Homewood. Also 75 in Alabaster. Near 80 degrees in Tuscaloosa and 77 right now in Moundville. So very warm evening all across central Alabama. So trick-or-treating could not be better. Temperatures are going to stay in the upper 60s overnight tonight. So it's going to be a warm start tomorrow morning, but that's because we have warm, soupy air funneling in here ahead of a cold front, and that's why we could see the potential for some strong storms. So any showers we see this evening will be in West Alabama. Most of us stay dry. No impacts for trick-or-treating. I feel sorry for the kids back in Arkansas, as well as parts of Texas, Dallas, and Houston right now dealing with severe weather. This is the band of showers and thunderstorms that's going to be tracking towards us. We have a tornado watch in effect back in through Texas as well as Arkansas. Flash flood warnings, severe thunderstorm warnings, even tornado warnings this evening. So as this line tracks towards us, it will start to weaken. This is all along a cold front that is really going to cool us down by the end of the week, but we are going to be dealing with a soggy and possibly stormy morning, so make sure you stay weather aware tomorrow morning. Heavy downpours are likely anywhere from 1 to 2 inches possible. Strong damaging wind gusts are also going to be our main threat. The farther south you go, that's where the tornado threat will be. But the line is going to arrive early tomorrow morning in West Alabama. We're talking anywhere between 5 and 7 a.m. Between 7 and 9 through the Birmingham Metro, and then late morning, early afternoon in East Alabama. So you'll see that on Futurecast. We say cloudy throughout the afternoon or throughout the evening tonight, and then here come the showers and thunderstorms tracking throughout the morning. So very soggy morning commute. That's why we want you to stay weather aware, because even if we don't see severe weather, we could have gusty winds and very heavy downpours. That is not a good combination for the morning commute. By tomorrow afternoon, we are clearing out, but then tomorrow evening, we have the actual cold front making its way through. So colder air starts to move in, and we could see a few showers along the cold front as it slowly tracks through. By Friday, we will gradually start to clear out and cool down, struggling to get out of the 60s. Don't forget to fall back when you go to bed on Saturday. Now we'll take